nature, the heaven under our feet and over our heads is something we can never control, but is always for us to rejoice and enjoy the peace and beauty it offers. Hey guys, welcome back to our channel for another brand new video. In today's episode, we'll be discussing what will happen if the North Pole melts. So want to know what exactly will happen if the North Pole melts? Not so fast. Before we begin, make sure to like, share, subscribe, and turn on post notifications to get notified every time we upload a new video. Okay, let's begin. What happens when the ice cap on the top of the Earth melts? Well, first off, let me just say it's not good. Wait a second, you guys, let's do the math. To begin with, climate change is already something we face. We, the naughty little Homo sapiens, have thrown a lot of carbon dioxide into the air, which is causing climate change. Yes, lots of it. And with the likes of it, it's not even a little bit good. The super climate change will change the global temperature, causing the ice caps in the north to melt. And obviously, when the ice melts, it becomes water. Does that mean the Earth's going to be filled with water? If so, to what extent will the sea level rise? Well, you're at the right place because we're going to answer all these questions one by one. Nature, the one thing which we should take care of as much as our life, but unfortunately, we, the relentless human species, kill it in all the ways possible. Climatic changes are pretty standard, but things take a turn when it crosses the limit. The abnormalities will start to originate when the global temperature does the worst thing it can do to nature, and that is the melting of the ice in the Arctic. If you think, well, what's the big deal in the melting of ice 1,000 kilometers away from us, you're wrong, because the consequences of this process can wipe out the entire human race. Yes, that includes you and me too. The temperature of the world is steadily rising, making the Earth hotter and hotter. According to NASA, if we consider the year 2000, it's understood that the hottest 15 years can be recorded in this period. This blocks the climatic features to support the Arctic's environment to keep the ice as it is. The Earth System Science Center director at Pennsylvania State University says that the Arctic is a natural freezer and asks us to be careful with pity. Would you ever like it if the ice in your freezer melted? Well, that's an important reason he mentioned too. There must be equal concern for the Arctic ice, as it plays a significant role in determining our residence on our house, the Earth. So what happens if this occurs and there's a complete meltdown of the Arctic? The disappearance of this ice will be affecting everywhere in the world and not just the surrounding area. It prevents global warming, and after its existence, the world will experience the effects of global warming. Even though this is a severe issue, it is nothing compared to the rising sea level's consequences. It's said that the rise in sea level could be up to 20 feet, which is almost 3.63 times the height of an average human being. If this happens, the entire population will be diminished. A vast majority of cities will be destroyed, especially coastal communities like Florida, New Jersey, Maryland. These places will be drastically affected in such a way that they can never recover from it. These sites are currently experiencing more instances of a flood, and increased sea levels will be a death sentence to these people. Let's now consider that all the ice in Antarctica, Greenland, and mountain glaciers worldwide melts due to the increasing temperature. The sea level would rise up to 70 meters, that's 230 feet. Yes, you guys, these facts are hard to believe and accept, but if proper actions are not taken right away, according to scientific evidence, you and I will not be alive to regret it. Here's the crazy thing, the more this happens, the bluer the planet will become, as it would significantly shrink the land area. The scary part is that we have no idea how exactly things will happen. Data like how much, rate, or time is entirely unknown. But here's what we do know, the glaciers do not melt like how an ice cube melts at room temperature. This is due to the reactions of meltwater and seawater, which increase the rate of melting and retreat. We can understand that the glaciers and ice developed throughout centuries can vanish in countable years. The damages in the Arctic ice will have diverse effects on the weather on the planet. It could lead to extreme weather conditions that are more likely to be in the eastern US. This is the best example that everything is connected in nature. The weather is the reason for the melting of ice, and this resultant becomes the initiator of extreme conditions, and the cycle of doom continues. This will lead to frequent droughts, heat waves, high rainfall, hurricanes, and last but not least, storms in the tropical region. We all know what happened in the US in 2018. I'm referring to the bomb cyclone and endless streaks of hurricanes that occurred. Did you know all of these are connected with the melting of ice kilometers and kilometers away from there? According to the study done in 2017, the melting ice was also the villain behind the unhealthy smog layer in China. Now I have a question for you guys. Y'all ever heard of the term permafrost? Well, permafrost is any ground that is permanently frozen or up to at least 2 to 3 years and is seen in areas consisting of many mountains and in places with high altitude, which is the North and South Poles. Permafrost covers a massive size of the Earth. Now you might wonder, why on Earth am I talking about permafrost?
Yeah. You gonna tell me why?
Let me break the news to you. Permafrost is actually on the way to a massive crisis, and the main areas of focus are Alaska, Canada, and Siberia. These gigantic natural grounds contain an unbelievable amount of carbon, that is almost 1,400 gigatons of it. In other words, they are natural reservoirs of gas. 1,400 gigatons are 2 times the amount of carbon present in the atmosphere right now, and melting it will unleash an endless amount of toxic carbon. And like we said in the beginning, more carbon dioxide means more melting of the Arctic ice, which will not just affect our livelihood, but also damage the home of the complete wildlife. I know most of you are stunned by the effects and are seeking ways to stop the Arctic ice from disappearing. The one thing that you and I can do on a day-to-day basis is to cut down greenhouse gas and carbon emissions, which, if done collectively, will bring about a change in slowing the ice from disappearing. In other words, the rate of global warming and ice melting is inversely proportional, meaning if you reduce global warming, ice melting will stop, and if you increase it, the ice will melt more and more. Another idea proposed by researchers is to cover the Arctic with reflective substances like silica and glass beads to reflect the effects of the sun and to send it back into oblivion, thus isolating the ice into a closed system where it remains in the frozen form without the effects of the atmosphere. The merits of this process are that silica has no adverse impact on nature and the glass beads stick to the surface of the ice and moisture when in contact. However, this tactic still has not come into action as it is still in the fieldwork. But this scientific process can be our savior from various natural calamities. In the meantime, the most we can do is regulate our carbon footprints. I'm not saying we can prevent it entirely, but maybe we can do a few things I mentioned earlier, which might help reduce the impacts and possibly save the world. Every year, a small portion of the fresh water in Greenland and Antarctica melts into the oceans, and it would take hundreds of years for all of it to melt and go away. But at the rate of climate change, this might happen in a way that we don't expect and would be a pretty devastating situation. So let's try our best and prevent climate change in every way possible so that we don't have to go through anything I mentioned today. Alright guys, we've almost come to the end of today's video. I know what we saw and heard today wasn't pleasing, but these are the facts we as the children of Earth have to know. Which part of the video did you like the most? Do you guys think we'll have to go through such drastic times, or will science help us attain control over it? Let us know your views and opinions in the comments below. Do you like watching this type of content? Then what you waiting for? Hit the like button and make sure to subscribe to our channel, and we'll keep you entertained with more cool videos. Also, yes, don't forget to press the bell icon. We'll see y'all again in another video. Until then, bye folks.